So good morning students. So yesterday we were discussing about cellular respiration. Okay. So what is cellular respiration? Just I will recall you in quick. So what is cellular respiration? The food is broken down in the presence of oxygen to liberate energy. That is called as cellular respiration, which is occurring inside the cell. So it is of two types: aerobic and anaerobic. So aerobic respiration means the respiration occurs in the presence of oxygen. Okay, anaerobic respiration means the respiration occurs in the absence of oxygen. Oxygen is not present there. Now if you see anaerobic respiration, again it is of two types: fermentation and lactic acid anaerobic respiration. What is fermentation? Fermentation we have seen in yeast. Yeast is a unicellular fungi. So in that fermentation occurs. And lactic acid anaerobic respiration. Lactic acid anaerobic respiration occurs in some bacteria like lactobacillus, which is present. Lactobacillus bacteria is present in the curd and even in the human muscle cells. Okay. So in the absence of oxygen, yeast carries fermentation, and we have in our textbook human muscle cells. So during vigorous exercise, means when you are doing severe exercise, then our human muscle cells will carry lactic acid anaerobic fermentation. Okay. Now what are the end products of the anaerobic respiration? Like when you see the fermentation, the end products are ethanol or ethyl alcohol. Carbon dioxide plus energy. Energy is liberated. That energy is nothing but ATP. During lactic acid anaerobic respiration, lactic acid is produced and energy is produced. So in these are the end products. This is very important question. What are the end products of anaerobic respiration, or what are the end products of fermentation? What are the end products of lactic acid? Now, if you see how many ATP are produced during anaerobic respiration, only 2 ATP are produced. 2 ATPs are produced during anaerobic respiration. Okay. So we have seen most of the time in our body all the cells will prefer aerobic respiration. Most of the time all the cells in the body will prefer only aerobic respiration. So but when you are doing vigorous exercise, the muscle cells will be continuously working. So they need continuous supply of oxygen from lungs to heart, from heart to all the body parts. The oxygen will take time to come. So in the meantime, the muscle cells will do anaerobic respiration. The muscle cells will carry on anaerobic respiration. So what happens inside the muscle cell? The glucose which is present is converted into pyruvate. The pyruvate is converted into lactic acid and energy is liberated. So due to formation of lactic acid in the muscle cells, we feel pain when you are doing exercise in our hands or legs or something. So lactic acid will be deposited as crystals on the muscle cells, and until it dissolves in the blood, we will be feeling pain. So lactic acid will be dissolved in the blood, and again it will be converted into glucose. So okay, clear? This is about anaerobic respiration. Now let's talk about aerobic respiration. Okay, let's talk about aerobic respiration. If you see aerobic respiration, So most of the cells in the body, most of the cells in the body prefer most of all the cells in the body or any organisms will try to prefer only aerobic respiration most of the times. Only when oxygen is not available, they will go for anaerobic respiration. But all the time, the cells will be preferring only aerobic respiration. Why? Why the cells will be preferring aerobic respiration than anaerobic respiration? Because if you see the aerobic respiration, the glucose. So we know the structure of glucose is 6 carbon. So this is the 6 carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I hope you remember the formula of glucose, C6H12O6. In photosynthesis we have written. So this is the formula of glucose. So in aerobic respiration, the glucose present in the cell is completely converted. All the bonds are broken. All the bonds are broken. And it is the 6th carbon is converted into single carbon. That is carbon dioxide. Okay. All the bonds are broken and the glucose is reduced or converted into single carbon atom. That is carbon dioxide. So along this we will have water and energy. Plus heat also. Heat is also liberated. So, there is no need to write, but just remember, heat is also liberated during aerobic respiration. Okay? So, aerobic respiration, the 6th carbon molecule is broken down into 1 carbon, that is single carbon, very simplest form. The complex molecule is broken down into very simplest form, that is 1 carbon molecule, carbon dioxide. And water is released, energy is released. So here the energy is almost 38 ATPs. 38 ATPs are released. Okay, from aerobic respiration, you will get almost 38 ATPs. Yeah. So from aerobic respiration we get 38 ATPs. Okay. So from one glucose is oxidized or one glucose is broken down to get 38 ATPs. Means 38 ATPs means lot of energy. From one glucose you are getting 38 ATPs. So that's why cells prefer doing aerobic respiration. When you compare to anaerobic respiration, if you see anaerobic respiration, so just remember this, in aerobic respiration, the glucose is completely broken down into carbon dioxide and water. That is complex 6-carbon molecule is broken down into single carbon molecule, that is carbon dioxide. And almost we liberate 38 ATPs during this process. When you see anaerobic respiration, okay, when you see anaerobic, so now you consider this as anaerobic. Respiration, what is happening? The 6-carbon glucose molecule, the 6-carbon glucose molecule is broken down into fermentation. What is happening? It is broken down into ethanol, C2H5OH. This is the formula of ethanol. Means only it is broken down into 2 carbon. Remaining is left over. Okay, if you see lactic acid also 2-carbon molecule. Lactic acid is also a 2-carbon molecule. Okay. So So if you observe the 6 carbon molecule in anaerobic respiration, it is broken down into only 2 carbon molecule. Ethanol is formed. Even the lactic acid is also 2 carbon molecule. And if you see here, carbon dioxide is liberated. Here carbon dioxide is out. Okay. So if you see 2 carbon molecule and 1 more carbon is there. So remaining 3 are still present. Okay. So that's why only less ATP are generated. But if you see aerobic respiration, all the 6 carbon, all the 6 carbon atoms are broken down to liberate 1 molecule of carbon dioxide. Okay. That's why we get more energy in the form, in the aerobic respiration. Just don't confuse. In anaerobic respiration, the glucose molecule is broken down. The glucose has 6 carbons. Okay, it is broken down into 2 carbon molecules. This is the main product. Okay, this is, it is broken down into 2 products and forming ethanol. In lactic acid also, lactic acid formula, in lactic acid formula, we have 2 carbons only. So it is incompletely broken. The glucose is not completely broken. It is incompletely broken. That's why we are getting less energy. But if you see aerobic respiration, in the presence of oxygen, the glucose is completely broken, okay, to give 1 molecule of carbon dioxide. That's why we get more energy in aerobic respiration. Clear? So now in aerobic respiration, what happens? The glucose which is present inside the cell. Now imagine this is our cell. So glucose which is present in the cell is converted into what? Pyruvate. This is a common step for both aerobic and anaerobic respiration. Common step. So glucose is converted to pyruvate. It is a common step for aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. Where this occurs? It occurs in the cytoplasm. This step occurs in the cytoplasm. Okay. So this step is called as glycolysis. This step is called as glycolysis. So glyco means glucose, lysis means broken down. Okay, glyco means glucose is broken down. That's why it is called as glycolysis. Okay, glucose which has entered into the cell is converted into pyruvate. That is 3 carbon. So I will write the carbons here. It is 6 carbon. Now it is converted into 3 carbons. So we will get 2 pyruvate molecules from 1 glucose. You are getting 2 pyruvate molecules. Okay. This step is common for both aerobic and anaerobic respiration. Now depending on the presence of oxygen. Okay. If oxygen is available, the pyruvate will go for, if oxygen is available. What happens? The pyruvate will go for aerobic respiration. Aerobic. Okay. If oxygen is available continuously for the cell, then the pyruvate will go aerobic respiration. And what are the end products? Carbon dioxide, water, plus energy. Okay. So almost 38 ATP are generated. So, try to understand. Now, glucose is converted into pyruvate, means 1 molecule of glucose is converted into 2 molecules of pyruvate. So, if you see like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, here it is broken. So, this one becomes 1 pyruvate. Now, this is another pyruvate. Okay, this is another pyruvate. Okay. So, 1 glucose molecule is broken down into 2 pyruvate molecules. So, So this step is common for both aerobic and anaerobic respiration. And this step is called as glycolysis, because glucose is, lysis means broken down. So glucose is broken down, that's why it is called as glycolysis. Now pyruvate is present in the cell, that is in the cytoplasm. If oxygen is available, pyruvate will go for aerobic respiration. It is continuous aerobic respiration, and it will generate, the end products are carbon dioxide, water and energy. More ATP is generated. Okay. If oxygen is not available, what happens? If oxygen is not available, then what happens? Now pyruvate, if pyruvate is there, if oxygen is not available, what happens? It will go for anaerobic respiration. Okay? It will go for anaerobic respiration. Clear? If oxygen is available, it will go for aerobic. If oxygen is not available, it will go for anaerobic respiration. Clear? Okay? So, now, this is in your textbook, just a simple brief description is given in your for cellular respiration. This is very important flow chart you need to remember, and if cellular respiration question is given, you should definitely draw this flow chart. Okay, so just, this is very simple. See, glucose, the 6 carbon molecule, okay, I will write like this. 6 carbon molecule is converted into pyruvate, 3 carbon compound. So this process is called as glycolysis. Okay. Now what happens? Pyruvate. What will be the fate of the pyruvate? When pyruvate is there in the cytoplasm of the cell. Now if oxygen is present, it will go for what respiration? Aerobic respiration. So it will go for aerobic respiration. So what are the end products of aerobic respiration? Carbon dioxide, water and energy. And it occurs in plants and animals. All the cells of plants and animals will carry aerobic respiration in the presence of oxygen. When, if pyruvate is there now, oxygen is not available. Oxygen is absent. Now what will it go? It will do, it will go for anaerobic. Anaerobic respiration. Okay. So either lactic acid, is formed along with energy is liberated. It is mostly seen in human virgin cells and lactobacillus bacteria. And in yeast, it will be produced ethanol plus carbon dioxide plus energy. Okay. This is about cellular respiration. Clear? So very important topic. So if you have any doubts, just write down and ask me. Okay?